guests participating in this debate on demands for grants in the Ministry of Social Justice and Empowerment. Sir, I don't want to be rhetoric or I don't want to attribute any motives or I don't want to make a speech of blame game politics. Sir, till now I heard from the Congress Party as well as the Bharatiya Janata Party. Sir, Bharatiya Janata Party MP, he says all is well, whereas Congress Party MP says nothing is well. Sir, who ruled this country for the last 67 years, sir? Both the political parties, Congress as well as Bharatiya Janata Party. Sir, what is the amount allocated for the budget for social justice and empowerment, sir? It's only 6,565.95 crores. Out of which plan is 6,500 and non-plan is 65.95 crores. Sir, I have seen the budgets introduced by the Congress Party earlier. Not more than 5,000 crores. Sir, who is blaming who? And is it everything is going fine? Not at all. Sir, I have gone through the budget estimates of 2015-16 introduced by this government, sir. Last year it was 6,542. In revised estimates, they have reduced to the extent of 600 crores. Sir, the population of our country is 120 crores, out of which half the population are from the OBCs, SCs and STs, more than half, 70% in fact. Sir, what is the budget allocated for these sectors under this head, that is social justice and empowerment? Sir, we are debating on the demands for grants. So, I want to give some suggestions as well as recommendations on behalf of my party, sir. Sir, on four counts particularly, because in view of the time constraint, I would like to specify only on few issues, sir. That is with regard to scholarship of students, reservations for SCs and STs, and social sector pensions, sir. Sir, with regard to the scholarships, in this budget estimate, what is the amount we are giving for the scheduled caste children, sir? For a day scholar, we are giving 100 rupees. And for a hosteler, we are giving rupees 700 per month. Sir, this amount is too low. And I suggest that at least it should be 1500 rupees per month for a boarder in the hostel. Because many of the scheduled caste students are now being educated through hostels in all the states. Sir, with regard to the Rajiv Gandhi Fellowship, which was introduced by the UPA government earlier, the amount, the total scholarships are 2,000 for SCs and 667 for STs, sir. Sir, this is a large country having 29 states and 7 union territories. Population is 120 crores. And with regard to the, I would like to suggest that these scholarships should immediately, it is in this budget, already the budget is introduced. I request the Honorable Minister to see that these scholarships are increased to 4,000 and 2,000 respectively for SCs and STs, sir. And with regard to the OBC, sir, now they are giving only 300 under this head, Rajiv Gandhi Fellowship. At least they should be increased to 4,000. These are the scholars who have completed their post-graduation. They want to do some research work. Sir, can't the UN government help at least to the extent of 4,000 across the country? I request and suggest the Honorable Minister to see that some allocations are made for this demand, sir. Sir, with regard to the reservations for SCs and STs, as per the 2011 census, the population among the SCs and STs has increased to 17% for SCs. I request that the Union Public Service Commission, which is conducting exams for civil services, sir, for both for SCs and STs, at least they should increase to 17% and for SCs and 9% for STs. This is as per the 2011 census, sir. But as on today, the reservations for SCs and STs is not on par with the population of 2011 census. Sir, with regard to the sir, now jobs for SCs and STs, particularly in the government jobs, they have reduced, sir. Sir, employment in the government sector now has reduced and the private sector has increased. Sir, at least we should make a clause in the contracts, agreements with the contractors, when the government is spending huge amounts for construction worker as well as for infrastructure companies, at least they should hire some employees among SCs and STs. At least that proposal should come from this ministry, sir. They have not made such proposal till now. At least at this stage, they should at least make some advisory at least to the state governments, so that while awarding contracts, they should insist for that they should at least employ 17% of SCs and at least 9 to 10% of STs. They are doing infrastructure workers. The money is from the exchequer, from the Consolidated Fund of India. They have a role. So I request that this ministry should make some recommendations and see that such reservations are implemented among the private sector also. Sir, with regard to the pensions, sir, how much we are giving, sir? 300 rupees for the disabled and rupees 200 for the aged old, sir. Sir, I will come to my state, sir. My state, my chief minister, K. Chandrasekhar Rao, immediately after swearing ceremony, he announced ASARA pensions for the aged old, sir. Sir, we are giving rupees 1000 per month to each individual, sir, aged old, who come under that category, BPL category. Sir, the amount allocated in the state budget, Telangana state government budget 2016-17 is 4,693 only for this pension, sir. The total budget of the social justice in the country is only 6,000, sir. Only for one scheme we have allocated such amount. Sir, with regard to the housing for the deprived, disabled person, we are giving 1500 rupees per month, sir. For the disabled. Sir, we have introduced a scheme called Kalyana Lakshmi, that is, at the time of marriage for girls among the SCs and STs, we are giving rupees 51,000, sir, at the time of marriage. And now our government, our chief minister, day before yesterday, announced that he is going to introduce this Kalyana Lakshmi even for the backward class communities. Sir, the total budget allocated is around 1,000 crores for this scheme, sir. Sir, these are the social schemes by which we can do some justice to the deprived sections of the society. Ours is a small state, sir, 3.5 crore population. We have allocated such budget. I request the Honorable Minister here to see and to make a request to the Union Cabinet, to the Prime Minister, to allocate some money so that the demand for grants for social justice and empowerment can be...
Please conclude.
Last, sir. Sir, even for the scheduled caste, scheduled tribe and backward class students who are studying in hostels, we are giving fine rice, sir. There is rice, quality rice for the boarders in the hostels. Sir, with regard to this ministry, sir, for the last many years, non-governmental organizations, they are doing service for the disabled, mentally retarded children, tribal children, blind children. Sir, all the proposals which were sent by the state governments to this ministry... Sorry. Different. Sir, so what is the amount, sir? Now the NGOs, they are coming to the